Hey guys, it's Phoenix. I'm on 1.12 pre-release 6. This is a new snapshot that was released last night while I was live streaming, so I took the opportunity in that live stream to talk to you guys about the new changes and basically what is coming in 1.12 in terms of technical issues and command blocks. Now, I do apologize for this later video because something did pop up in my head. I did want to address it to you guys so you're well aware of what is new. And it is pretty cold here, so I do apologize as well if I'm slurring the words unintentionally. So I had a lot of thoughts about the conditionals in command blocks, specifically functions. Now, a lot of people have been commenting this on my channel. I've received upwards of about 50 comments, whether it be on a video or a live stream, talking about why functions are so difficult to work with. And the main issue I want to talk about is this. Command blocks have a 3D environment. You can work with blocks, you can work with repeaters, comparators, and that comes with a lot of added benefits because with comparators, you have the conditional aspect. And also with command blocks, you have the conditional tag here that you can set and trigger if you wish to. Functions do not have this. Now I'm going to switch over to the function screen. I did make a little bouncy bed mechanic here. So if you jump on a bed, you get a bit of a jump boost. And that disappears instantaneously. And if I jump off, I don't have the jump boost anymore. If I jump on the bed, I have a jump boost. So a very simple mechanic to inform you of how you can quickly input stats to create conditionals in functions. So let me switch over quickly. I will talk about why I think conditionals won't be added. So this is quite straightforward. And you can also use the new if and unless to your advantage here. Now, of course, if and unless are best used when you have more than one function, because that's basically how if and unless work. I am adding a stats command to the player for a success count. Now what this means is if this is executed successfully, your success count tag will be added to 1, and the stats command allows you to put this into an objective. And I've already created the objective in game. Now if you've spotted this already, good on you. You don't actually need to have two commands for this. You can just simply use detect. But I want to simply emphasize the score for bounce will be added by 1. Now this can be any command you want. I could probably give the player a full set of leather armor. If they have the full set of leather armor, the stats command will be 1. It doesn't matter at all. But just disregard the fact that you don't need two commands here. The stats command is going to set success count score to 1 if this first command is successful. You just have to add the execute at P prefix and then have a stats command. That is all you need to do for a conditional in functions. Now, for the more technical minds out there, if this doesn't work for every single command, please let me know. Now, I know this is daunting for a lot of you. That's why I do expect a lot of people to still use command blocks because it's a simple click of a button for it to be conditional. Of course, entirely up to you. Don't worry about whether I am going to be using functions or command blocks. It's completely up to you what is more comfortable for you to use. Don't be swayed by my opinions. And everything else here is rudimentary. Essentially, I get a jump boost if my score is 1. And if it's not 1, I don't get a jump boost and I reset the scores at the end. Now, why am I talking about this? Because last night in the live stream, a lot of people were concerned about whether conditionals will ever be added with functions. Now, let's go over to the changelog. Okay, so here we are. And the changelog specifies this. And of course, it's using conditionals in the context of if and unless. So my gut feeling, and this is purely speculation, and I know how much you guys love speculation, conditionals probably won't be added for what you guys want. So the whole idea where a command is successful and the subsequent command is conditional on that, I don't believe they will be added in the future, if ever. So you're going to have to either use command blocks for the comparator benefit or the conditional button on the command block if you wish to use the conditionals in that way. Otherwise, you're going to have to pick one or the other. Unless there's another way, there's a third way. Probably there is. Multiple functions, that's another way I can think of. Otherwise, you're going to have to be stuck with this. Because I believe Mojang is not going to be implementing them anytime soon. It's not the end of the world. Of course, if and unless do work in that regard. Of course, you could also use conditionals in that way. It's not entirely generic though. And it probably can't be used in every situation. So hopefully you guys got something out of this. Pre-release 6 does come with a lot of bug fixes, so I didn't really make a video on it, but this is something that has been concerning for a lot of people, and I do want to address it. So the best way, I guess, is if you just simply want to do something like this. Chain, conditional, always active. Or the alternative is, of course, comparators. That works as well. So entirely up to you. I will be using functions. The stats is okay, it's just success count. you don't really have to read up on stats in any way. It's just a success count tag. So nothing too daunting, but I know it is a fairly advanced command. So thanks for watching. Leave a like, subscribe for more creative content, more updates like this. Hopefully 1.12 will be out in a week. That is my approximation at this point. Thanks for watching. Take care.